to discuss few important topics in Java. So they are Java variables, data types, and operators. So let us discuss Java variables and data types and operators. So any language, if you start learning, we have to learn step by step. So first of all, we learn alphabets, then we will learn how to make a words and sentences, then we have to learn how to write a larger paragraphs. Similarly, even any programming language also we have to learn in the same fashion. So first we learn what is variable, how to define the variables, what are the data types, what are the operators. So first we have to learn this, and then slowly we'll start writing your complex Java programs. So first of all, let us focusing on Java variables. So what is Java variables? So here, a variable is a container. A Java variable is a container which can hold a value. So for example, here, if we want to store some, in mathematics also, you will see like this, x is equal to, I say 10. So what is the meaning of, what is x here? X is a variable. X is a variable which can hold some data, which can hold some data. So when I say 10, x is equal to 10, so currently x value is a 10. So later, if I want to change, you can still change. X is equal to 20. Now, what is the latest value of X is 20. So the 10 is overwrite. So 10 is gone. So the value of this variable keep on changing. We can change this value of this variable every time. So that is the reason we call it as a variable. So variable is a container which can hold some data. Variable is a container. Not only the numeric data, sometimes it can hold characters, sometimes it can hold string data. So different data type we have. So all kinds of data can be held by this variable. So variable is a container which can hold a data. Okay. So, but in Java, whenever we are storing some data in a variable, we must specify the type of data. Okay. We must specify the type of data, what kind of type we have to store in this variable. So for example, I want to store a numbers in a variable. Let's say I have a variable called as A, and I want to store a number inside this variable. So in that case, we must specify what kind of data we are storing inside this variable. So that is comes under the data type. So here we must specify int. Int is nothing but a data type. So integer is nothing but a data type. So when I say a variable as an integer, so this variable can hold only numbers without a decimal numbers, without a decimal. Only numbers will be held by this variable. So as soon as I say int a is equal to 10, what happens in the memory is, in the memory, it will allocate some space to this variable and the value will go and store here. Okay. Suppose if you are storing long value, let's say 10,000, 50,000, okay, like this. You have a huge number like this. Then int may not support. So you have to go for another type, like a long int of A, and then you can store larger number. So int and long int both are same. Only the difference is a location, size of the memory. So if you want to store a short number, 2 digits or 3 digits, integer is fine. But if you want to store a larger number like this, then you have to define that variable is a long int. Okay. And we have also another type called a short. Short. These are all number data types. So when I say short here, it can just store only one digit. So just 1 or 2 digits, not more than that. So if you want to store a short number, you can just go for the short. It will allocate only small type of memory, small minimal memory. And if you integer, little bigger memory. Or if you say long int, and again, more use memory. So that depends on the memory size. There are multiple types are available. So most of the times we use int type because this is most relevant. Always int type can hold the data. Okay. So these are all number types. So whenever you are creating a variable, and if you want to assign some value to that variable, we must specify the data type. As per the Java, we must specify the data type. And similarly, suppose if you want to store a decimal numbers, I have a decimal numbers, then you have to go for another type called as a double or float. So these two are also comes under the number data types, numeric data types. but these variables can hold decimal numbers. Let's say float A, I can store some decimal number like this. And when I say double, also we can store double number. So, but this time you can store a bigger number. Okay, so double is almost feasible when you compare with the float. So these are all another data types. These are all comes under one category. Okay, number data types. And we also have string type, and we also have char type, we also have boolean type. So these are all different data types. So what we have to understand here is, if we want to store a value inside a variable, we must specify the data type. If you want to store numbers without decimals, just define that variable as an integer type. And if you want to store a decimal numbers, define that variable as a float or double. Or if you want to store a characters, define that variable as a char type. Or if you want to store a string in a variable, or string is nothing but multiple characters, collection of characters, then you have to define that variable as a string type. So these are all different data types. So now what we have understood is, what is this variable? So variable, this is called variable declaration. This is called variable initialization. So in Java, we can try in two different ways. So when I say here, integer A. So this is just a declaration part. This is called variable declaration. So A is an integer type. We can store a number. Suppose I want to assign a value into the A, I can write one more statement, A is equal to 100. So this is called as a initialization. So declaration and initialization. So here we declare this variable of type integer, and if we are assigned some value to the A. So we can also write single statement instead of writing two statements. Declaration plus initialization. So directly specify the variable name is equal to 100. So declaration and initialization, both we have. So this is declaration plus initialization. So we can combine both of them. So either we can write this way or we can write this way. So this is how we need to declare the variables in Java and assign the data type and store the values inside this. So this is a simple understanding of Java variables. Now we have a data types. So in Java, there are two kinds of data types, basically primitive and derived data types. But here I have not listed out derived data types, but normally there are two kinds of data types. So one is primitive data types and second one is derived data types. So derived data types are comes under a primitive or like integer, double, boolean, okay, and character. So these are all comes under the primitive data types. And string and array list, hash map and set list. So these are all comes under the derived data types. So derived data types and primitive data types. So what is the basic difference between these two? So primitive data types are not classes. They are just a keywords in Java. So we can just normally use primitive data types to store the data in a variables. When you come to the derived data types, these are predefined classes in Java. So that's the reason these data types are starting with the uppercase letters. So these classes are starting with uppercase letters because these are all classes. And we can also use them as a data type. Okay. So in the coming sessions, I'm going to discuss all these things slowly one by one. So basically there are two kinds of data types, primitive and derived data types. So integer, double, boolean, character, these are all primitive data types and these are all derived data types. The basic difference is primitive data types are just a keywords and derived data types are basically a classes, predefined classes. And we can also use them as a data type. So that is the only basic difference between these. Now here I have listed out a few primitive data types. So here integer. So under integer, byte is there, long, short, integer. So these are all different types. So I said long int, right? So that is exactly equal to long. So byte means 1 byte, 8 bytes, 2 bytes, 4 bytes. So based upon the size, we have to select proper data type. So almost int is irrelevant. Every time most of the times we use only int because this is enough to handle all kinds of data. But if you want to store huge number like 5 digits and 6 digits, then go for the long. Okay. And float. So this is can hold decimal numbers. And float and double comes under the float category. And char is another type. So which can hold a single character. And characters we have to include in the single quotations. And there is another type called as a boolean. So here we can just store either true or false. Okay, boolean variable can hold either true or false, only two values without having double quotations and single quotations. So these are all the Java data types. Let me just quickly show you one example how to use these data types. Let me just create another example, new class, and I will name it as a data types demo. Sorry. Data types and demo. So these are all very, very basic concepts in Java. You don't have any interview kind of questions on this. I will tell you what are interview questions which are important going further, okay, wherever it is required. So first, focus on the basic concepts, how we can start writing your Java, how to write a system.println statement, how to use data types, how to use variables. So this is once we get the basic understanding, slowly once we started your programming, then I'll tell you what are all very important things which we need to focus for interview purpose. Okay. So data types demo, this is my class name I have given. I'm taking just the main method, then finish it. So within the main method, I have to write your code. So here I'm just define few variables. Okay. I'll just define few variables and I will create integer type of data. So integer, let's say a is equal to 100. This is integer type of data. So int type of data. So this is just a comment, okay? Slash slash is representing a comment. And if you want to comment multiple lines, suppose you have written some junk data like this. I want to comment this. So what you have to do is, before that use slash star, and at the end also use star slash. So Java will ignore these statements at the runtime. It will not execute these statements. So this is called multi-line comment. And if you want to comment a single line, just say slash slash. So slash slash will comment a single line. Okay. So now, so I've defined few variables with a different type of data. So I'll just say double d is equal to a decimal number. Let's say 15.5, some decimal number. And character. So char c is equal to characters. We have to include in single quotations. So if you want to store a characters in a variable, we have to include them in single quotations. Just a moment. Okay, so single quotations we have to include. And then we have another type called as a boolean. And remember, all these are lowercase letters, okay, keywords in Java. And we cannot use these keywords as a variable names. And variable names also can be have multiple characters. Suppose when I say A, you can also say ABC is equal to 100. So ABC itself is a variable name. Okay, so you can use multiple characters or a single characters. And within these variables, you can also use underscore, but you should not use special characters. Okay, so remember this. These are all naming conventions. You will know slowly once you start practicing this. And so integer, double, char, and the next type is boolean. So when I create a boolean variable, I can store either true or I can store only the false. Okay, so boolean variable can accept only true and false. So these are the basic types I'm going to use. So there are other types also there, but we don't use most of them. So the basic data types are from numbers, we use integer and double, character and boolean. Suppose if you want to store multiple characters in the sense it is a string basically. So if you want to store a string in a variable, then how we can? So we have to define a string variable. String s is equal to some variable name is equal to, here I have to put the string. So if you notice here clearly, so these are a primitive data types. String is a derived data type because string is a predefined class in Java. So that's the reason it is giving a different color. Okay. So string is a predefined class in Java. We can also use string as a data type. So that's the reason I said create a one variable of string type and I have stored a string. So strings always we have to include in the double quotations. Okay, remember this. So I have created few variables which contains some data. Now I want to print the data in my console window as an output. So how we can print is system.out.println. Just specify the variable. Okay, just specify the variable name. Then this statement will go and print that value which is present inside this A. Now when I run this code, it will give you 100. So A contains 100, but we should not. Okay, so suppose I want to print value directly, I can just print like this. Just run this code. It is prints 100. So whatever you have given in this println, okay, that will be printed directly in the console window. But if you want to print this value, and we can just refer that variable. That's it. So whatever value we have stored in this variable will be printed here. And similarly, I will also try to print the values of other variables. This is your D, this is your C, and this is your B, Boolean. And also I'll create one more statement to print the string value. Okay, so let's run this code. So now we got all the values from every variable. So this is a A value, this is a D value, C value, and a B value, and then string value. So we got all the values. So this is the way we need to just create a variables and assign the values. And at the time of printing, we can just refer the variable name in system.out.println statement. And here in system.out.println, here system is a predefined class. So I will just discuss about this in the coming session again, because we need to understand few more important things before understanding this one, system.out.println. For now, just remember system.out.println is a command which will print an output in our console window. Okay, so S is a uppercase letter. Remember, don't write single lowercase letter. Okay, this is uppercase letter. All right, so now I have created few variables which contains some data, and I have printed them. So in our console window. So this is how we need to define the variables, assign the values, and refer those values by using variable name.